Lee Daniels, The Butler, opened last weekend to critical acclaim and topped the box office. But the film was inspired by a Washington Post story on Eugene Allen, who served 8 presidents during a 34-year career as a White House butler. Reporter Will Haygood wrote that story in 2008, the same year America elected its first black president. Haygood sat down with me earlier to talk about his success. Will Haygood, welcome to Reliable Sources.
Thank you. Good to be here.
So Lee Daniels, The Butler, a top grossing movie over this past weekend. You've got huge stars like Oprah Winfrey and Robin Williams in this movie. But a lot of people might not know that the whole film started as an idea from a story that you did in 2008 in The Washington Post. So tell us a little bit about Eugene Allen and why you thought his story was so compelling.
When I started the search, I was literally looking for a ghost. But I knew I wanted to find a maid, a laundry person, a shoeshine person, a worker inside of the White House, because that's the most powerful address in the world. Mm. And if I found an African-American worker, then during the 50s, they were still treated outside of the White House as a second-class citizen because they didn't have their full rights. And I thought that saga, their life, whoever I would find, I thought their life bracketed up against the life of then Senator Obama's victory would be a very compelling story.
So how did you find Eugene Allen?
A phone call came in from Tampa, Florida, and the lady said, there is a gentleman by the name of Eugene Allen. And if you can find him, I don't know where he lives at, but the last time I saw him, he was exiting the White House and was getting inside of a taxi cab. So she said, I think he lives in the Virginia, Maryland, D.C. area, and so you ought to start your search there. And so I got out phone books for like 4 straight days. It's a fairly common name.
Wow.
Eugene Allen, and I just started cold calling every Eugene Allen and say, all the neighboring cities, towns outside of D.C., Virginia, Maryland, mm-hmm. because if he was catching a taxi cab, then I just said, well, he must live in the region. And on the 57th call, a gentleman answers the phone and I say, my name is Will Haygood. I'm a reporter for The Washington Post and I'm looking for Mr. Eugene Allen, who I think worked in the White House for 3 administrations. He said, I am that Eugene Allen. However, I worked for 8 administrations from Harry Truman to Ronald Reagan.
Wow.
And I almost dropped the phone.
So then you knew you had a story. So,
yeah.
And no one had talked to him in 34 years of service in the White House.
Yeah, 34 years. I went over there, of course, the very next, a day later because his wife said, yes, we'll talk to this writer, but you tell him that we both have doctor's appointments tomorrow.
Right.
And so I waited a day, fairly nervous, hoping that they wouldn't change their mind. And I went over there and sat with them throughout a whole day. And at one point, she said, honey, you can show him. And I didn't know what that meant. And he got up, frail man at that time, and asked me to hold his arm. He took me down the basement, and he turned on the light. It was like being swooped through a magical curtain into the land of Oz. There were all these photographs of him and President Truman, him and President Eisenhower, and President Kennedy, President Johnson, President Ford, President Nixon. And there were letters to him from these presidents.
Wow.
And there were pictures of him and various celebrities who had visited the White House. It was astonishing.
Yeah. So tell me a little bit, quickly, how it came from being a newspaper story to actually becoming a movie script. How did this all come together?
Well, Laura Ziskin, great movie producer who made the Spider-Man movies, unfortunately, she passed away before the movie was finished. But she was the one who called me first, and she wanted the rights to the story, and she got that, and Mr. Allen was still living, and she also soon thereafter hired Danny Strong, great screenwriter, Emmy award-winning screenwriter. He wrote the script for both Game Change and Recount. And so this milieu was right up his alley, and you know, so he came in and saw the civil rights epic quality of the story, because Mr. Allen served in the White House during some of the most tumultuous moments in this nation's history. He was there and heard the echoes and the ripples of the murder of Emmett Till, the murder of Medgar Evers, the missing civil rights workers in Mississippi, Schwerner, Goodman, and Cheney, and, of course, the passage of the landmark civil rights bills in 1964 and 1965.
Exactly. So what was interesting to me about this is that the butler in the movie, his name is Cecil Gaines, not Eugene Allen.
Right.
And there's some aspects of his life that are different.
Mm-hmm.
Everything from having a son who was involved in the civil rights movement who he clashed with, to having a mother who was raped by an overseer in a plantation. So were you concerned at all that the fictional story might overshadow Eugene's real life? And was there any concern that people might walk out of the movie thinking that was Eugene's life?
I think really it comes down to a filmmaker's art and a filmmaker's approach. I think when people go see the movie, as they have been doing, thankfully, that, you know, if they know the Eugene Allen story from either the original story that I wrote or the book that I've also written, I think that they'll see that the figure on screen is represents the essence and the soul of this man who served all these years in the White House.
Now, one thing that interests me, we've had another recent movie about black domestics called The Help.
Uh-huh.
And that got a little bit of a backlash from people who said, well, you know, mainstream Hollywood loves focusing on black people who are in servants' positions,
mm-hmm.
and they get saved by white people.
Well, I really think, you know, that this movie is a different sort of movie. First of all, it's inspired by a real man's life. And it's also a movie about the intersection of power and civil rights in this country. And I think it's all too rare that we see stories, epic stories of African-American love on the big screen. And I think that's all to the good. I think that the movie ultimately shows the great things that America has done, even with the torment that we had to endure going from segregation to integration. This man was born in 1919 on a southern plantation and lived in real life to get an invitation to see the swearing-in of the nation's first African-American president. I just think it's a very rich story.
That's an amazing story. And Will Haygood, you've gone from covering Nelson Mandela to now telling a story about a butler that's had a worldwide impact. Thank you so much for joining us on Reliable Sources.
Thank you very much. Great to be here.